Hola y bienvenidos. Hello everyone and welcome. We are happy that you have chosen once again to be with us on this 32nd Sunday in Ordinary Time. Thank you for being here each and every week. Next weekend, November 14th and 15th, begins our new Mass times schedule. The evening Mass times have been moved to 4 p.m. and we have added an extra English Mass at 11 a.m. There will be only one Spanish Mass on Sundays at 1 p.m., and the daily Masses will be at 7 a.m. starting Monday, November 16th, on Mondays, Tuesdays, and Thursdays. Friday morning Mass time will remain the same at 8:30 a.m. Thanksgiving Day Mass will be on Thursday, November 26th at 10 a.m. We invite you to bring your bread and wine for a blessing, whether you are here with us in the pavilion or watching at home. Tickets for that Mass will be available on Tuesday, November 24th at 5 p.m. We are in the process of making our Christmas Mass plans, so be on the lookout for more information in the bulletin very soon and get ready to sign up for the Mass of your choice. We are planning on having Masses in the Damien High School parking lots in order to accommodate the larger crowds. We miss you all and we keep you in our constant prayers, and we are with you in spirit. Our celebrant today is Father Mike. So let us begin our celebration in prayer. For the quiet intentions in our hearts and for the Mass intentions of all those loved ones who have gone home to heaven this year, as we keep them in our hearts during this month of remembering. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And now we send you greetings of love, virtual hugs, and I invite you to join Candace and Trevor in our opening song.
Bless the Lord.
Good morning. As we gather, let us begin. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, the love of God, the mercy of Jesus Christ, and the peace of the Holy Spirit be with you all. The time is a gift that God gives us through which we might come to discover God and the beautiful things of God. Our lives are wonderful gifts with no guarantee of tomorrow. Life is precious, short, and fragile. Jesus calls us to realize that now is the time to seek the compassion and peace of God for ourselves and those we love. When our lives are so filled with busyness, that there is no time for the people that matter most in our lives.
Kyrie eleison. Kyrie eleison.
When we allow the challenges of life to overwhelm us and take life from us,
Christe eleison. Christe eleison.
When we feel the need to strive for more, to be better than others, or to get more material things that falsely fill our brokenness,
Kyrie eleison. Kyrie eleison.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. God, beyond time and space, open our hearts and minds to your loving presence found here, which fills our beings with your light and life. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
Lectura del libro de la sabiduría. Radiante e incorruptible es la sabiduría. Con facilidad la contempla quienes la aman. Y ella se deja encontrar por quienes la buscan y se anticipa a darse a conocer a los que la desean. El que madruga por ella no se fatigará, porque la hallará sentada a su puerta. Darle la primacía en los pensamientos es prudencia consumada. Quien por ella se desvela, pronto se verá libre de preocupaciones. A los que son dignos de ella, ella misma sale a buscarlos por los caminos. Se les aparecerá benévola y colabora con ellos en todos sus proyectos. Palabra de Dios.
Reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Christian community of Thessalonica. We do not want you to be unaware, brothers and sisters, about those who have fallen asleep, so that you may not grieve like the rest who have no hope. For if we believe that Jesus died and rose, so too will God, through Jesus, bring him with him those who have fallen asleep. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Together, let's rise.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus told his disciples this parable. The kingdom of heaven will be like 10 virgins who took their lamps and went out to meet the bridegroom. 5 of them were foolish and 5 were wise. The foolish ones, when taking their lamps, brought no oil with them. But the wise brought flasks of oil with their lamps. Since the bridegroom was long delayed, they all became drowsy and fell asleep. At midnight there was a cry, "Behold, the bridegroom, come out to meet him." Then all those virgins got up and trimmed their lamps. The foolish one said to the wise, "Give us some of your oil, for our lamps are going out." But the wise ones replied, "No, for there may not be enough for us and you. Go instead to the merchants and buy some for yourselves." While they went off to buy it, the bridegroom came, and those who were ready went into the wedding feast with him. Then the door was locked. Afterwards, the other virgins came and said, "Lord, Lord, open the door for us." But he said in reply, "Amen, I say to you, I do not know you. Therefore, stay awake, for you know neither the day nor the hour." The Gospel of the Lord. There was a Sunday school teacher who was testing the children in her class one morning to see if they understood the concept of getting to heaven. So she said, "If I sold my house and my car, held his big garage sale, and gave all money to the church, will I go to heaven?" The children answered, "No. If I cleaned the church every day, mopped the yard, and kept everything neat and tidy, will I go to heaven?" Again, the children, they told, "No." "Well then, if I was kind to animals, gave candy to the children, and loved my husbands, will I go to heaven?" Again, the answer was, "No." "Well," the teacher continued, "how do I get into heaven?" A small girl got up and told, "You have to die." So today the readings bring the usual warning about preparation for end of our time, or end of the world, or when we pass to another world. The readings tell us that a searching, watching, and growing heart is essential for our lively, dynamic faith in God. So the reading asks us whether we are ready for these events and how we are preparing for them. So when we reflect on today's gospel, what is the meaning of that? There's two meanings we can see that. One is local and another one is universal. The local meaning, we can say that the people of Israel, they were waiting for the Messiah. But when he came, they were not ready to accept him and ready to listen his teachings, not ready to follow him. Another meaning that because those who are keeping and following the commandments of God, they are the wise virgins. those who are failing to practice and follow, they are the foolish virgins. The universal meaning is that we cannot borrow our characters, our attitudes at the end of our time, but we have to practice from the beginning. That makes us a way to reach heaven. That makes us to become a good person in the society. So the first reading, it helps us to understand, because every one of us, we are created as wise men and women. So in the first reading, the book of wisdom, it gives us several meanings that. The wisdom means going beyond mere knowledge to the depth and breadth of the mind-boggling issues of life. It means understanding and insight. It means the best way for one to relate to God and to other people. It means seeing every thought and word and deed in relation to the every purpose of our life. It is the person who searches for the true wisdom and really desires it will not have far to seek. It is easy for him to attain the wisdom. The divine wisdom is never denied to all those who are worthy and are honest in their guest. Wisdom is ever present to the man who seriously thinks on life and its meaning and value. The Christian who shares his wisdom with the needy is the true Christian, whose personal wisdom is ever radiant and unfading. So how are we going to prepare, or how can we keep our lamp burning, or how we keep ourselves alive? We have to make sure that we have enough oil for our lamps. So the oil that is, it represents, or it gives different meanings that. The first one is the oil, it stands for our personal relationship with God, who is the source and power behind our good deeds or fruit bearing. So the relationship, we have to deeper through our prayers to know God more and to strengthen our spiritual life as well as the earthly life with others. The second thing, that's the scripture, we see that oil stands for the symbol of the Holy Spirit. Because when we submit our work, our intentions, our purpose to the Holy Spirit, that He fills our deeds with power and effectiveness. The third one, the oil stands for the character and the Christian values, which we cannot borrow from others. No one can help us. We have to practice and we have to live from the beginning to end. That makes us to enter the heaven. The other meaning, the oil stands for spiritual capital. That's our merits. All that we built up by good works, concern for needy and acts of justice. That helps us to burn our lamp. And also the oil refers to the real Christian faith. The oil is the spirit of reconciliation with God and with others, and willingness to share our lives and its blessings with others. And the oil also stands, or it gives other meaning, that the faithful and obedient discipleship, giving ourselves fully for His mission and giving our life for God. So as we are celebrating, let us reflect and pray. As the Psalm 62, it says that, O God, You are my God, for You I long. For You my soul is thirsting. My body pines for You like a dry, weary land without water. Come then, Lord, come quickly and grant us the gift of your Holy Spirit so that we may be ready to meet you. May we be found truly poor in spirit in order that we might possess the kingdom of heaven. And may we be found with pure hearts in order that at last we may truly see God. Amen. Let us profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. And by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried and rose again on the third day in accordance with the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. United with Jesus, let us put forward all our prayers and petitions and ask God's prayer, blessings, and his grace.
For our clergy, and all faith leaders in this time of illness, pain, and incivility, that they lead all people in the common teaching of love of neighbor and self. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our elected officials, that their efforts bring physical and emotional healing, economic security, and lead all of us to work for a unified nation. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For each of us, that we may be wise in our life choices and support the health and well-being of ourselves and each other. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the sick of our community and for all who have fallen asleep in faith, that they may rest in the presence of our God, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Let us pause for a while and pray for our personal intentions, the people, those who asked our prayers. As you listen to our prayers of need, help us in what we say and do to better service you and each other. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Standing here in your presence. In a grace so relentless, I am
one.
By perfect love, wrapped within the arms of heaven, in a peace that lasts forever, sinking deep in mercy's sea.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all his holy church.
Look with favor, we pray, O Lord, upon the sacrificial gifts offered here, that celebrating in mystery the passion of your Son, we may honor it with loving devotion. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For when your children were scattered afar by sin, through the blood of your Son and the power of the Holy Spirit, you gather them again to yourself, that a people formed as one by the unity of the Trinity, made the body of Christ and the temple of the Holy Spirit, might, to the praise of your manifold wisdom, be manifest as the Church. And so in company with the choirs of angels, we praise you, and with joy we proclaim.
Santo, Santo,
Santo, Santo,
Santo es el Señor,
Santo es el Señor,
heaven and earth,
heaven and earth,
earth full of your glory,
full of your glory,
Hosanna in the cielo,
Hosanna in the cielo,
Hosanna in the cielo,
you are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like a dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly in his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was entered, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Save us, Savior.
Save us, Savior.
Savior of the world.
Savior of the world.
For by your cross.
For by your cross.
that for us we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church is spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity together with Francis, our Pope, Jose, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and to all who have died in your mercy, welcome them in the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. The Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
With your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed. For the people, those who are virtually being with us during this Holy Eucharist. Lover of our souls and gentle companion of our journey, we have opened ourselves to receive you in your fullness into the very depths of our souls. As you take root in us, stretch the boundaries of our hearts and minds, increase in us as we decrease. May your holy presence in us be reflected in our thoughts, words, and everyday works of love, bringing light, healing, and compassion through us to our world in great need. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen. Let us pray. Christ, our light and our life, fill us with your life-giving presence, empowering us to be your hands, your voice, your mercy and love. Continue that transformation in us through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go and announce the gospel of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.